The problem is not the problem. The problem is your attitude about the problem. Captain Jack Sparrow. Hello, how is everyone today? This is my Mizuora glass water bottle. It comes with a protective cover, but it looks prettier like this. It has smoky quartz crystal inside. I'm obsessed with this. I promised you guys that I would do a Q&A video, so should I get closer? Let's scoot in, shall we? And I'm sorry about my mic being in shot, but this is how I can get better audio because the mic has always been too far away. All right, guys, so I asked you guys on Instagram to send in your questions on whatever you'd like. I said literally, ask me anything. And this was about 4 hours ago. We have a ton of questions we gotta get through. Hopefully my battery will hold up. Let's find some interesting ones, shall we? This is a good one. Friends with benefits with someone while you're still in love with your ex. Thoughts. I don't like to tell people what to do with their life. I just speak from my own experience, and whatever worked for me, I will talk about that. Being in a friends with benefits situationship is very, very emotionally draining because you are with this person and you do everything with this person that you would do like a life partner, basically, and you're not. You know, they're not your life partner, they're not your twin flame, they're not your soulmate, they're just somebody to pass the time with. And I'm not gonna tell women or men or anyone what to do, but personally, I wouldn't be in that situation, especially if I still had feelings for someone else. I'm not coping with those feelings with an ex. I think that whenever you break up, it's important to take some time for yourself and getting to know yourself and getting over any feelings before jumping into a situationship. Now you might think like friends with benefits, it's not a big deal. It's not like I'm getting feelings for them, but you could, you know? You could end up getting feelings for someone you don't wanna get feelings for, somebody who doesn't have feelings for you, who wants to fall for someone who doesn't like them, you know, the way they like them. So steer clear of the friends with benefits, just be their friend and work on yourself, work on getting over that ex. The right person will come along and it'll just be the right timing. You'll be ready both emotionally and intellectually for sure. What is inspiring you right now? I love you too. Ooh, what is inspiring me? I think the future is definitely inspiring me a ton. And also what's inspiring me is becoming the woman that I want to become. Just harnessing in my powers and harnessing in my strength, going for my dreams. My dreams are really inspiring me right now, my goals too. And I kind of have like a bit of fear. I'm just afraid that this might not be for me, but I am going to try it. I'm going to do my best and figure it out and see how it'll work out for me. But the risk is really inspiring me right now. And also just like random things that are currently inspiring me, beach scents and like natural stuff, natural scents. I am gravitating a lot towards like essential oil, like lavender. I feel more of a pull towards the earth, like organic stuff. So I feel like I need to take a vacation in nature soon. It's really cold here where I live, so I mean, not super cold, but it's cold for me. I'm really getting called to be outside more, to be in nature more, so that's inspiring me too, and inspiring just where I'm headed, I guess, and my plans for the near future. Also, turning 25 is inspiring me a lot. I know a lot of people would probably be scared to turn 25, but that's really inspiring. What time do you start your day, and what does your morning routine consist of? I start my day probably around 8, the earliest 6. This morning I woke up at 4:45, just naturally. My alarm is always set for 6. And I woke up naturally this morning and I was like ready to go. I was super energized. So I'm like, wow, what is this energy? Something happened to me in my sleep and now I'm able to do all this. So I just let my body naturally wake up, and then that way I'm listening to my body's circadian rhythm. Problem is that I'm a huge night owl by nature, so mornings are a little bit more difficult for me. But my morning routine, like I said, I like to naturally wake up. I usually don't get on my phone right away. My phone is like away on the other side of the room. And I usually like to listen to an inspirational podcast. I'm really loving Kaylin's Coffee Talk. Also, Earn Your Happy podcast.
Just stamped out. Do you know what I'm saying?
Oh, that's her. The Earn Your Happy podcast by Lori Harder. I love her. She's so funny. Couples Therapy by the Neistats. Casey and Candace Neistat is like one of my favorite podcasts. And they stopped it for a while, but they just came back with a new episode. I was so excited to listen to that one because it's so funny. It's just really relatable. They're both so relatable. I love Candace. honestly, like, I would love to meet Candace Neistat. Gary V Audio Experience also is a great podcast. Motivational and business entrepreneurship kind of stuff. Definitely highly recommend. And I try to meditate for at least 10 to 15 minutes or just sit with my eyes closed or journal. Later on in the morning, I'll try to get a workout in. So I'm trying to implement more good routines into my life. And my morning routine is definitely something I play around with a lot. But since I am trying to reach new goals and do new things and work on projects, I need to make as much of my time during the day as I can, because I find that once the sun starts to set, I can't focus anymore, which is something that I absolutely hate. During those hours, I don't know if this is just me, but those hours where it starts getting later, maybe like 5 o'clock up until the sun goes down, I have anxiety. It's like this weird anxiety that I feel like I need to do so much and I can't, or like I feel the day is over and then I can wait a while, and then at night I can get really productive, like from 9 to 2 a.m. So since my mind works that way, really I only have a few hours, especially during the winter, to be productive, because there's so little sunny hours. So the sunny hours last from like 7 a.m. until 4:35. So that's the little window I have to be really productive. Wow, okay, so this question was asked twice, like right next to each other. How do you protect your energy and your positive mindset, or how to keep a positive energy and attitude when surrounded by negative people or other people? I have a video on how to protect your energy. It's still very, very useful for today. I did it about a year ago. I will link it down below because I feel like it's a very important video. Keeping your energy positive around negative people. If you are an empath, which is a person who feels other people's emotions and energies and feelings, it's just like if somebody around you is in a bad mood, your best friend's in a bad mood, you're probably gonna get that bad mood. So you gotta be aware of that. You gotta be aware of how other people's feelings affect you. Are you a person who picks up other people's bad attitudes? My battery's about to die, so I'm gonna have to stop this video. Be right back. Is there a 100 calorie pack of natural almonds? Next question. Maria asks, can you please talk more about why you decided to go plant-based and its health impacts? That's a great question. I went plant-based vegan mostly for, I think, health reasons. And then when I got into it more and I did a lot more research, because I really didn't do too much research beforehand, like I didn't watch slaughterhouse videos or any of that. I just knew that it was healthier. My mom had gone vegan and I was a huge carnivore, guys. I was born and raised here in Texas. I'm Hispanic. You know, in our culture, there's a lot of meat. People in Latin culture don't believe that you can have a real meal without meat. Like if you have a meal without meat, it's not considered a real meal, which is something that I always have to deal with when I go to Latin countries, even though like Colombia has actually been really vegan and vegetarian friendly, which is awesome because it used to not be like that. A couple years ago when I went to visit, it wasn't like that, but now in almost every restaurant I could find vegan options, which is great. So anyways, for me to completely leave meat was kind of crazy. I went vegetarian for a while and then I went full on vegan. And what I have noticed for me, just, I've been vegan for about 4 or 5 years now, I think. It's been a while. What I notice is that I don't gain weight as easily. Before, on a standard American diet, I did gain weight pretty easily, so I had to exercise a ton. As a vegan, I generally stay pretty slim, thick, whatever you want to say. I do stay at a healthy weight without even trying. Now, I'm not like a fitness guru or anything, even though I am going to the gym more and lifting more weights again because I want to get into really good shape. You are more conscious of what you eat as a vegan. You are conscious that you need to eat more fruits and vegetables and of what vitamins you're putting into your body. You just become really in tune with your body and the earth after you become vegan, because you are forced to eat more fresh, organic things because you're more aware of what you're putting in your body. And I truly believe from a spiritual standpoint, now this is not necessarily health standpoint because I'm not a doctor and I can't tell you how good it is. I'll just tell you how it's worked for me. But from a spiritual standpoint, I believe that in order to be in high vibration, in order to be more at peace and to have a healthier, thriving body, a body that is built on life, is to leave death off of your plate. And I know you could say technically you kill plants to eat them. Yeah, yes, but they do not have a central nervous system like a mammal would, or a cow or a chicken or anything, any animal. After I got into veganism for a while, then I started realizing the ramifications of eating meat are to our planet. And just in animal agriculture, there are so many CO2 emissions, a huge pollutant of the earth, to basically have these factory farms. And the way they treat and kill these animals is so barbaric. And I do not want to put a piece of something in my mouth and digest it and put it into my body and my spirit when it's gone through so much stress and so much pain and so much death. Not eating animals has led me to be more conscious of the earth, of the creatures, of myself, everything that I do to my body, because I feel like in respecting the animals, I've respected myself. In respecting the earth, I'm respecting myself. There are many arguments in favor and against veganism or being plant-based. I do think that veganism is the future. I truly, truly believe that. Have I ever suffered from depression? What helped it? Love your channel. Thank you, Val. Yes, I did go through a bout of depression back around 2015-ish. Just some things went on in my life that weren't the best, and my life was kind of like crumbling around me. But it was a depression where I literally felt like my life was over. There was nothing left for me to live for. I could go and be social and things like that, but whenever I was alone, I would just sob and sob. I felt completely broken. It was awful. I wasn't worth anything, and it was from that point I decided I didn't want to feel like that anymore. I didn't want to feel that pain anymore. I didn't want to feel worthless anymore. So I got back into the law of attraction. I had known about the law of attraction prior to that, but I kind of fell off of it. And all these bad things happened, and then I got back on it, and then that kind of gave me the push to live and make decisions and face my demons, face my struggles, and overcome them instead of letting them consume me. And that's how I got out of it. I know for everyone there's clinical depression. I know that there's so many things out there that we can suffer from traumatic experiences, or just from our childhood, or just because our brains are chemically wired like that. Everyone has to deal with mental health at some point in their life. I hope that you understand you can get out of it. Even if it's something that they say is gonna be with you for the rest of your life, I believe if you push and you push and you push and you focus in on that as much as you can to get out of your depression, or just to find help, if that's the most you can do, then that will put you way ahead of the game. That will put you in where you need to be, and that way you can heal from whatever is hurting you. How do you cope and deal with stressful happenings in your life? I'm full of anxiety. So I said in my live stream that I haven't had anxiety in like 3 to 4 days, which is a while for me, especially I've had a lot of struggles this past month. I mean, not so bad, but just emotional stuff. Every day I'd wake up with anxiety, and today I woke up with the most amazing energy, and I honestly feel it's because I allowed myself to feel through my anxiety instead of trying to necessarily mask it or get rid of it. And one thing that has really helped me is the saying, you are exactly who and what you need to be right now. You are exactly where you need to be. You are in the right place. You are doing well. And just that idea, and I'm trusting more in God, trusting more in the universe, kind of putting my worries onto God and focusing on the present moment, living in the present moment, enjoying my life right now. Even though it's not perfect, it's not where I want it to be yet, I'm going to enjoy it to its fullest. Not waiting so much for happiness, not waiting for a problem to be solved or something to come into my life or someone to come into my life in order to start feeling good now. That thought has helped my anxiety so incredibly much, you guys. And also breathing through my nose, closing my mouth and breathing through my nose and doing correct tongue posture, I believe has also contributed to the fact that I am feeling amazing. It is truly incredible how, just by changing a few things with the human body, just how some physical things that you may do can change your entire mindset. These almonds are so good. This is an interesting question. Are you awake or woke? Like 100% of the time conscious. So she's asking if I'm woke. I would like to think so. I think to be going around telling people I'm woke is kind of like acting like I'm better than other people or something. I do feel a very heightened sense of things. I'm aware of a lot of things, and I think about a lot of things, and I see things for what they are, which is why I really don't get worried too much, especially when it comes to politics and social issues. In the end of the day, you have to know how this world works. Most politicians aren't our friends, and they're not doing things in our best interest, no matter what side of the aisle they're on. What's my biggest manifestation up until now? Working for myself, definitely. Being a content creator, getting paid to do YouTube. How can we overcome sugar addiction? I think it's like slowly taking more of it away. So like, if you usually drink sugar in your coffee, first day, take the sugar out of your coffee, instead put vanilla or cinnamon or whatever kind of apple pie spice you want to put in there or whatever. Any flavoring without sugar or spice so that it tastes good and it tastes different but it doesn't have sugar in it. And then the next day, take out something else that you eat sugar and then start finding healthier alternatives. I believe substituting like candy bars and things like that with fruits is really good. Just slowly do it. I think when you gradually do it and then you find yourself reaching for more sugar one day or you have a craving, you go to something healthy. Have like a healthy backup so that you won't be binging or anything on it. Any plans on visiting Toronto? Maybe soon. I've always wanted to go to Toronto. I've always wanted to go to Canada. I've never been. Do I meditate? Yes, I try to meditate every morning. What is my favorite crystal and why? I just started my collection. My favorite crystal is angelite crystal. So beautiful. It's a soothing blue color, soft blue color. I'm obsessed with it. How to know that a person is right for you? I think that only time will tell. That's why dating is so important, not jumping into commitment, but really getting to know somebody first before getting into a relationship with them is so important. What are your musts in a romantic partner? Love you. Love you too. And the ideal partner for me is somebody loyal, somebody caring, understanding, has goals and dreams, hardworking, definitely, intelligent is a must, absolutely. Somebody compassionate and giving. I really don't have like physical traits that I'm like, oh, I need this in a partner. You know, it's just about how we vibe. Also, style is very important. Do they dress well? Do they have manners? Are they classy? That's very important. A classy man is always a good way to go. I don't mean just classy in the way they dress, but their demeanor, how they treat people. What would be the one thing that you wanted to change in the world? I feel like there's always gonna be negative and positive things. The world will never be perfect, and even if you take away one negative thing, there will always be other negatives. So if I could change one thing in this world, it would probably be more love. I think that's what our world aches for the most. Oh, and reverse climate change, definitely. And make people more inclined to have discussions rather than go to war. What's my one bad habit? Oh my God, that's such a good question. Maybe it's my phone. Being on my phone too much. That's definitely a very bad habit of mine. What is my zodiac sign and do you believe in it? I'm a Pisces. And do I believe in it? I do find that a lot of Pisces have similar traits. I don't really believe like the day-to-day stuff. I mean, sometimes it is inspirational and it's kind of cool because it does resonate with my life, but I don't follow it word for word. Would you be a mentor to someone if they asked you? Yeah, I'd love to. I'd love to mentor people. That's what I thrive at, is just helping others, talking with others, being there for others. What's my favorite perfume? Okay, I have two. I'll be right back. Okay, so I have three favorite perfumes of all time. The vegan one that I absolutely love, it's vegan cruelty-free, which it's really hard to find good vegan cruelty-free perfumes. Gilded Fox by Pinrose Scents. I also love the brand of this candle, which is Skylar. This is the candle in Arrow. It smells so good, and they also have perfumes. My other favorite scent is Meadow. Those are from cruelty-free vegan perfume brands. Non-cruelty-free, non-vegan. I mean, this is the Juicy Couture Viva Le Juicy Sucre, which means sugar in French. Oh my God. This is like me in a bottle, which it's kind of sad that it's not vegan and cruelty free. This is the first bottle I purchased. I purchased this before I was cruelty free and I love it so much. I wish it was vegan. Wish it was cruelty free. And I'd buy bottles and bottles and bottles and I don't ever wear it. But this smells like delicious mahogany rum with like hints of chocolate and vanilla. It's very like warm and sexy and musty. Perfect for the holidays. Reminds me of the holidays, but you can also honestly wear this any time of the year, but I absolutely love it. And it has the most beautiful bottle ever. The French brand is called Comptoir Sud Pacifique in Vanilla Extreme. That's also me in a bottle in high school. That's what my high school scent was. And I would buy from them if they were vegan, but honestly, I wish I could just buy the scent so I could spray it on my pillow and just have the nostalgia. Like, smelling those gave me nostalgia. Would you ever have your own merch store? I love you so much. I love you too, Maria. I would love to do merch. I've actually have some general rough sketches and ideas in my head of what I would put on merch. Like, I would do like hoodies and shirts and hats, like stuff that I wear. I also want to make a journal. I want to do so many things like merch wise. When I'm done with this project, then we'll move on to the next. In your own opinion, what is the secret for a happy and meaningful life? Take care always and God bless. Thank you. I think in order to have a meaningful life, you need to be surrounded by the right people. Good people who lift you up and that you can lift up, and having relationships with others. It's also important to have goals and dreams, even if they're crazy. Think of all the people who had these crazy goals and dreams and then ended up revolutionizing the world and changing the world in so many ways. They were just following their crazy goals and dreams, and that gave them meaning. And through that meaning that they gave themselves, they were able to give meaning to so many more people, help so many more people, and create for the world and for future generations. So I think you need to keep that in mind, because a lot of times we have goals and dreams that aren't really our own. If your dreams don't make you scared to chase them, just make you feel like, oh my God, how am I ever gonna do this? Then they're not really your dreams. Don't get lost so much in pleasing others. Make sure that you please yourself first, and in all the love you give out is what you will receive. So make sure that you're spreading love to everyone, even the people you don't like so much. What is your life's purpose? Man, that actually makes me really think, what is my purpose? I've always had a calling to help people, to inspire, and just be a positive force on this earth, and also to help the animals. I know I sound like a straight hippie in this video, but that's just always how I felt. I've always felt very connected to earth, to nature. Ever since I was little, I loved being outside. I loved being barefoot. I loved running through the woods. I loved making tree houses. I was just like really happy and free, carefree child. And the way that kind of manifested over time was very idealistic and dreamy as a child. And then as I grew up, I started realizing that life is not all perfect and wonderful. And just because it's not perfect and wonderful doesn't mean there's anything wrong. And I went through a really tough time in my life, and I went through depression. I always felt like I didn't have anyone there for me. I always felt alone, and like I couldn't ever talk to anyone about it, or nobody would ever understand, because everyone else was happy except me. I was the one that was down, and I was the negative person in the room, and I hated feeling like that. So that was what pushed me, because at that time I had a makeup channel. That's what pushed me to do more spiritual videos and self-help videos and things like that, because I didn't have anyone to go to, and I make my channel about that. That's what I choose to focus my channel on, is being the support or the light for someone, or helping someone see through a situation in their own life that maybe I went through, not able to talk about it. That way I can help others through my own experiences. So I guess that could be my purpose. I don't know, it could change. You know, things could change, and I believe that we're always evolving and growing and changing paths and direction throughout life, and that's fine. I think it's just important to be true to yourself, your strengths, what you enjoy doing, what brings you fulfillment. How can I stay focused on me and not overthink while having a long distance relationship? You see, long distance relationships take a lot of work and a lot of commitment from both partners, a very strong drive to be together and to be loyal to each other. If that doesn't exist, it's going to be very hard to continue this relationship, because it's very stressful. What you have to do is understand you are a separate entity. You are somebody completely different outside of this, not different, but you're a completely separate person outside of this relationship. You will always be by yourself. And I think long distance is good for people who need to focus more on themselves, because they don't have to be with their partner all the time. But I understand you will have trust issues or having your partner far away, so that can lead to anxiety and you feeling like you can't focus on you because you're always worried about what they're doing. If you find that you're having that issue, number one, talk to your partner about it. Are they doing something that is causing, or is their behavior causing you to have these feelings and anxieties and mistrust? Or if they don't talk to you, or they refuse to talk about it, or they don't change, think about if this situation is for you. Maybe they're for you, but before taking a big step like getting married or something like that, you go and you live with them, or they come and live near you, and see how it works out. If you're having issues with trust, try to stay with them for a prolonged period of time, or have them come stay with you for a prolonged period of time to kind of get to know each other and get to know how each other works, and realize, oh, you know, they're not up to no good, there's nothing suspicious and whatever. But understand, like, a lot of your anxiety is just coming fear-based. If you've like been cheated on before or lied to before, you probably will have a bit of anxiety. But honestly, talk to your partner about it. Maybe they can help you evaluate if you want to still be in the relationship, and if you need to move or have them move so that you guys can be together and stop with the distance thing, because it's not easy. What are my plans for the future? I plan on moving to a new city. I'm not sure where yet. I want to travel near future for my birthday. I want to grow my brand, grow my business, become a CEO, share as much time as I can with my friends and my family, my loved ones. Those are more like goals, I feel like. But I'm kind of going with the flow now with life. I'm not forcing anything or trying to meet specific deadlines, really, especially when it comes to like my personal life and things like that. I'm just trying to enjoy the journey and the process, not rushing towards anything, and getting to really know myself. I'm turning 25, which is a milestone, probably the last birthday one should celebrate. I'm having fun, I'm loving life, and my plan is just to continue on where I am and try to make some physical moves, physical changes, keep creating. Berenice asked, I don't know if you answered this before, but how do you keep negative thoughts away, especially when dating someone? I'm not sure what kind of negative thoughts you mean. Is it trust issues, jealousy? Maybe they treat you bad, I don't know. But my number one is, if a person treats you bad or less than you deserve, you just shouldn't be in a relationship with them. I don't care how in love you are, don't put up with that. If you find it's jealousy or trust issues, talk to your partner. And if not, I think that a lot of jealousy and insecurity comes from past experiences. You can't have love without trust. And if you don't implicitly trust your partner or feel good about your partner, if your partner makes you feel bad or have negative thoughts, you need to reevaluate why you're in that relationship, because life is too short to be in a relationship where you're not happy and you're not fulfilled and you're feeling bad about yourself or anything, just about the whole situation, about life. No relationship is gonna be perfect, but you have to bring out the best in each other. And if your partner is bringing out anxiety and negativity in you, then evaluate if they're really the one. All right, guys, so I feel like this video is super long already, so thank you guys so much for sitting here with me and chilling out, and I hope your questions were answered and you got the info you needed. And if you guys want more Q&As, please be sure to hit thumbs up. I like Q&As because I can answer a lot of frequently asked questions about me, or just, you know, my thoughts on things, or just law of attraction, things like that. I'm very grateful for you guys. I'm grateful for each and every one of you. Thank you to those of you who submitted questions. I wish I could get through all of them, but we would be sitting here for about a day, because I could go on and on and on about any of these given topics. So thank you guys. I love you so very much. Always remember, no matter what you may look like, no matter who you are in this life, no matter what you're dealing with, your true beauty, your true worth, and your true power always come from within. I love you guys, and I will see you in my next video. Bye-bye.